Hey guys, Gatik here, bringing you coverage of the patch 2.6 PTS. In this video, we're going to take a look at the Kuat Driveyard's tactical flashpoint. And this is the intro cinematic. Because of some bugginess on the PTS right now, you will not be able to access this until after you complete the flashpoint for the first time. But I'm going to put this at the beginning of the video, so if you see me repeating some stuff, that's because I've already recorded my first run through of the flashpoint, and now I'm seeing the intro cinematic, so enjoy!
Don't be alarmed. I'm with the Republic Strategic Information Service, deeply embedded. I took a gamble you'd be curious enough about the malfunction I devised to stop a moment. A serious problem's brewing. One of the Empire's most feared admirals is about to launch an attack on Kuat Drive Yards. Kuat provides the bulk of the Republic's warship production. If the Empire takes control, we're in bad shape.
The Empire isn't exactly good for business. Tell me what I can do to help.
Had a feeling I wouldn't have to work hard to persuade a smart entrepreneur. There's no official call to arms, but if you were to simply show up, I'm sure Fleet Admiral Ego will be relieved to see you.
You don't think the Admiral will ask questions?
Not by then he won't. He'll have his hands full. Just be sure to get the proper clearance codes for safe travel to the Kuati fleet. This channel won't be secure much longer. I should go. Best of luck keeping Kuat Drive Yards in Republic hands.
If you continue this quest, I'm being told by Johanny Real, who is a fan of the show. Thank you very much for all the help, Johanny, telling me where stuff is on this area, that you can actually speak to some people you may know, and we'll see who those people are in a second. So I'm getting a clearance code here from this terminal.
Hey, pal! With each passing second we don't get assigned to a ship, our odds of holding Kuat go way, way down.
Kendra, there's a process! You can't just
you
go around
people?
Commanding things.
You might.
Well, I just did, 3G.
So you have. Regardless, I can't say I care for your imprecise characterization of the odds.
Maybe if you let Kendra get us on a ship, we could all have less talking and more blasting. I've been itching to shoot down imps for weeks. Give me a break with all the hugs and feelings, Wogawa.
There can't be peace for the galaxy with the Empire around. They'd never stand for it.
I concur. Why, in the first battle of Bothawui, I found the Empire rather savage.
Bothawui again, 3G? That all you can yap about is your big moment of victory?
Don't ever change, Ashy.
Hey, I'm just saying.
May I say, you're always just saying? One of us does not quite understand the meaning of that phrase, I'm afraid.
So that's a really cool throw-in that they put in there. I know a lot of people were upset that the new companions were just in the Galactic Starfighter and say a couple lines there. So that's really cool that they put that in to kind of give some personality to the different fleet companions that you have for your ship. And I think that's it, because now it's telling me to actually go to the flashpoint. So I will cut back to the video of me actually doing the flashpoint for the first time. In this video, we're going to take a look at my first run-through of the Kuat Drive Yards, which is a new tactical flashpoint. And what that means is it's available from all players from 15 to 55. So you can hop in at a group, and you might get matched up with a level 15, a level 37, and a level 42. This will be similar to how they're handling the Zerka flashpoints now. Actually, they've added the Zerka flashpoints into the same queue, so you can queue for all of them at the same time. So this is a pretty cool idea, in my opinion. Also, I've heard that this flashpoint is cool because it changes itself up every time you go in it. You'll have different objectives and things to do, maybe you'll have different bosses. I'm not actually sure, this is my first time running through it, so you'll be getting my first impressions of it right here. It's also a role neutral flashpoint, so your role does not matter. DPS and healers and tanks, they get matched up in any group, so this is also like Zerg flashpoints. Okay, so it looks like we're on the bridge of the Esalis. looking over, I guess this is Kuat here. And let's talk to this guy. Hello. Wake up, Jelani. Now this NPC here is the first Bothan in the game. So this has caused a lot of stirrings in the rumor mill that maybe Bothans are the playable race that we know is coming. I actually think that would be a pretty cool idea. I think it would fit. They're very similar to the Cathar in body type and, you know, pretty much how alien they are. I think if they could do Cathar, they could do Bothan. And there's nothing like a party ball. But yeah, I would definitely probably transfer one of my characters to be a Bothan, or maybe remake a Bothan character. Yeah. Hopefully many Bothans don't die in this flashpoint. Hello. Wake up. Let's see if this guy's saying anything. Okay. Yeah, the loading screen into this was a little weird. It didn't even have its own loading screen. Although this actually may be the area on the fleet. I've heard it's bugged. I will definitely check after. The only way to get into this area of the fleet is to do the flashpoint first, and it teleports you to this area of the fleet. Alright, so I think everyone's in. Clicked. Start the conversation.
Scramble all ships defending platforms 50 to 75. The imps won't stand a chance. There you are.
I know that voice actor.
I was told of your arrival. Fleet Admiral Baywan Ado.
I don't remember from where, but I know
you
that.
Honor me. Most fortunate your timing. But before we get into that, I take it you're aware of the importance of Kuat drive yards?
Remind me?
I try to stay up on these things. Bring me up to speed.
Since the dawn of the Republic, Kuat Drive Yards has been the exclusive supplier of many of our greatest
warships. Kuat Drive Yards have been the exclusive?
Without Kuat to make and repair our fleets, we're vulnerable. Give the planet to the Imperials, and we're finished. As we speak, the imps are mounting an attack on Kuat's main defensive control station. Their starfighters have also targeted related assets in Kuati space.
Are you asking for help with the space station, or out there in a ship?
I'll take your assistance however you'd like to provide it. Bottom line, we can't let the Empire take that station, and we won't. I need to get back to it now, but on behalf of the Republic First Fleet, thank you. May the Force be with us. Tell the Mindrum squad leader to stand by for revised objectives. Those imps won't know what hit them.
Alright, shuttle down to Kuat. So this is strikingly similar to the Essilis. Except we're not being invaded, we're just dropping down. Which is not necessarily a bad thing. The Essilis is probably the best flashpoint in this game. And I'll definitely be checking out the imp side of this also, so we can see how that is. They've done a great job with the new landing and, you know, taking off cutscenes. Like, that was a very well done. It was short and sweet, but I liked it a lot. Oh! Okay, we were just standing in space there for a little while. Now on to the killing. Take a look at the map. Alright, we have to destroy cannon emplacements. And that's a dead end. Oh, we're at the top. For some reason I thought we were at the bottom of there.
Imps are using the station's defensive ordnance to fire at our fleet. We need to take control.
It said they fixed one of the reasons that people get that lag bug, where things like speed shot will go off without actually going off. I'll tell you if I notice anything here, but it's kind of hard to tell with something like that. These guys are scavengeable. Oh, there's boxes back there. That's a bonus. I definitely want to do the bonus missions here. Let me just make sure that they're all cool with that. So standard droids, I haven't seen anything, any new models or anything like that. New Nerf flyby, just sad to see. It'll still do a decent job on AoE packs, so I'll still be using it for that. And let's down this force field generator. I like the fact that they said they were going to tie in the Galactic Starfighter into this Flashpoint a little bit, but so far I haven't seen or heard anything. That conversation really didn't... explain too much. And I guess it did explain what Kuat was, but... So far I haven't seen any of those like healing pod things that they had in the Zerka Flashpoints so that players can heal even without a healer. But this stuff has been pretty easy. We'll see if they have those at the bosses still. Shut down, find a way to disable the cannons. So I guess these are anti-air cannons that we're trying to take down. I wonder if those guys actually have a cone of sight. It looked like... I think you guys saw that, right? It looked like that one droid had a cone of sight. That's a cool thing that they could use in some fashion, some form or fashion. I don't want to miss any of those optional stuff. So, we might be clearing a little bit more trash than necessary. Mission there. Although these may be bonus missions for the sake of bonus missions, like bonus XP and bonus money, because these are leveling flashpoints as well. But in the group finder, when you're 55, you can only queue for this with other 55s. It looks like it's 1 to 54 and then 55 for this flashpoint. Which I'm not sure I'm a huge fan of, but it is what it is. There's one of the controls down. Oh, lifter. This is a boss? He's like a super elite, but doesn't mean he's a boss necessarily. And the boss music kicked on, so I don't know. Oh, that was for the bonus mission. That was the Elite Defender. There's also reputation achievements to gain in this flashpoint. I will go over that after this as well. Oh no, I've exceeded my maximum number of planetary commendations. Yeah, flyby just isn't what it used to be. But honestly, flyby needed a nerf. It's silly to have the strongest AoE ability also be the strongest single target ability. That's just ridiculous. I know it's sad to see it nerfed, but them's the breaks. I just see so much whining about it in the forums. I don't like it. We have two healers in this group, so that might be one of the reasons why this seems very easy. So we do have two healers. Although one may be DPSing at this point, who knows. Is there a box that way? There was a box on the other side. Yeah, there is one. I'm just gonna take these guys out. Get that box just in case. No, my flyby. Alright, so this should take the cannons down. Yeah, they are. Oh, we're on, like, the ring. I thought we were on the planet. We were actually on the ring. So this is like Halo. When do we get to get in the scorpion tank and go through the snow? So the way they said that, the get to the elevator and reach the objective, makes me think that there will be different objectives, like they said. They could have just written that to say go to the next thing, but they said go to the next objective, which is very neutral, and does make me think that this could be changed, and we will definitely be seeing that and taking a look at that. Okay. So the elevator is bugged. See if we can exit area and get back in. I've heard that exit area is also bugged. Let's go to the exit location and maybe that'll fix things. Alright. So this is the new area on the fleet. And walk back in. And hopefully the elevator will work for me this time. It looked like it worked for someone. The old music still gets me. It's been over two years since the game launched, and I still like the old music. They could definitely use some new music in the game, though. Okay. What? Oh. Actually, we just teleported down the elevator. Cool. Alright, so now we are reaching the starship assembly. You saw that one also had, like, the cone of... Actually... So those droids, the reprogrammed repair droids, have like a thing over their heads, so I want to see if I can just pass by them from behind. Oh no, what? That's weird. I thought there was going to be a cool little mechanic for that. Oh, whoa! There is the first boss, I guess. Johan the Hunter. I do not see any of the Healy Bobbers around. Although there's something green on the table. And as we all know, green means healing, so... Let's see what's over here. Electronic assembler access. Okay. Maybe that's nothing related to this boss. So this boss has the knockback and the cable pull. Too bad you can't cable pull. Sniper. Gunslinger, whatever. Yeah, he didn't do much. Not super interesting. Not a great boss. Into various parts and equipment for Starship. Wow. That's actually pretty cool. I definitely want to see who got that, and what does the purple thing do? Alright, so finish up these, all the boxes in here. Definitely have to take a look at that when we finish this, see if there's a vendor. Because I don't think that gives a rep, I think that was actually like a token for something new in Flashpoints. I wonder if it can get traded for Black and Starfighter stuff. That would be neat. So we're just cleaning up the boxes. Maybe we get a bonus boss for it. Keep finding these access codes. Oh, so we can unlock something. Maybe you can only pick one? Let's find out. So we've unlocked that. Can we unlock multiples at a time? Okay, so we need to find the weapons station. This is very interesting, and I think this guy's gonna look for the other. So if that's the case, that's a really cool idea. Oh no, maybe it is a puzzle. Let's see. Okay, so we just made something, I guess? I'm very confused. Alright, that's a ship. Testing assembled design. Let's see. Did it work? Oh, critical inability detected in ship design. Okay. Okay, so I guess we do have to make... This is actually really cool. This is like a puzzle boss in a four-man. Something I don't know if we've seen so far. Alright, so we need to figure out exactly what they're asking for. What are our options here? Or are they just gonna come? So apparently this is an event that can change how it goes. And we will be checking out other possibilities in the future videos. But I'm guessing if we had actually put together a proper ship there, these wouldn't be here, we would have passed this, and we'd be moving on already. I wonder if which scenario you get depends at all on if you do the bonus objectives or not. Okay. Go through here. Another elevator. Probably another bug. Wait on one. Bugged elevator. Alright, so this floor we're reaching security maintenance. I don't know if there were never any guys here or if they killed them all. I'm guessing there were never any guys here, but that's not gonna last for long. Because there's no reason to have all this empty space, you're not going to put stuff in it. Alright, Station Guardian 1.
The S3 programmed a company Troy to attack our forces on site. Take that thing out.
Okay. This one has the Healy Bopper things here, so hopefully this boss is a little bit more interesting. There's a little bit more going on with him. Probably stim up. I have a billion of these stupid exotech stims from when I copied this character over a while ago. So I'm gonna gain a small amount of rep. Alright, while we're waiting on people, I'm gonna go ahead and show you the reputation. The new reputation for this area is for the... where is it? I saw it yesterday. It's this one. The Republic First Fleet. So the Pride of the Republic Navy is its first fleet. Under the command of the fleet's Admiral Baywan Ago, the Republic's first fleet serves as a beacon of hope to civilizations across the galaxy, protecting the Galactic Republic's member worlds and corporate partners from the dark designs of the Sith Empire. Increase your standing with the Republic First Fleet by completing Kuat Drive Yards missions. So that's a little odd that the reputation is only for the singular flashpoint. You don't get anything through space. There's no daily area to complete, as far as I can tell. So that could be really annoying, getting up your rep with this faction. But hopefully you get a ton of rep per run, and it wouldn't be too much of a hassle to get full master. And at the top rank, you will get the professional... no, that is not it. At the top rank, you'll get Honorary Admiral, and at Friend, you will get Defender of Kuat. Honorary Admiral's a pretty cool title, so you gotta get all the way to Legend for that. Alright. So he has active support, which calls in these droids that empower him. He's gaining charges. He'll get fully charged at 100 stacks. So we have to kill these things before he reaches 100 stacks. Suppression droid puts down the suppression fields, which do some damage. I wonder if they slow also.
Enemy nullification assured.
Yes, they slow. They actually don't do any damage, it doesn't look like. Looked like he had a frontal cone there. Oh, and his stacks don't disappear when we kill all the droids. That is That's neat. So if we screw up one of them, it can screw us for later ones. Alright, so now we've got 50 suppression droids are out. We could probably ignore the suppression droids, since they only do the slow. They don't seem to be doing anything worse than that.
Enemy nullification.
There's a frontal cone, which doesn't follow anyone, so you just get out of that. It looked like they wanted it there to be that red, you know, the red triangle that they have. Whoa! Whoa! That doesn't look good. Alright, so he self-destructs with a big old bomb at the end. That's a neat boss fight! A great boss fight for a flashpoint. Some cool mechanics in there. I'm a big fan of that one. Good job. You get a couple blue rep tokens for that. Was that it? That was the flashpoint, I guess? I guess that was the end of that flashpoint. That was actually pretty cool. That end boss fight was nice. I like the fact that there was a cool puzzle boss, kind of, in the middle there. I'll be trying a different scenario in a coming video, so watch out for that, and I'll also be trying the imp side. So, hope you've enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.